Of the evening to everyone everywhere around the globe. Yes, happy new day, Canada. And for those of you around the world, just that you are having a wonderful time on this. Yes, Christmas Eve it is. Yep, it's bitter cold outside here in the GTA. I trust that you're bundled up for those of you who are doing your last minute going around and stuff like that and busy doing what you got to do. But let's play a little bit of this. And I'm just here for a minute just to, just to wish you all the best, glory to God, in what you do, and just to encourage us for a little bit. We bless the name of the Lord. Good evening. Good evening. You're in Jamaica? Oh my God, it's beautiful here in Jamaica. Oh, you know what? Again, good evening, everyone. I couldn't tell the last. I don't think I've ever spent a Christmas in Jamaica since I came to Canada. And I've been in Canada since I was 8 years old, and I've never spent a Christmas in Jamaica. I am going to try my best to make sure, God's willing, that I'm in Jamaica next year. Yeah, to see what it's like. You know, enjoy, my sister, enjoy. You know, I remember as a little girl, my aunt used to take us to, what is it, Grand Market? You understand, wee hours of the morning, is that it? You can't do them things, and no, unfortunately, enjoy it, my sister. Yes, Jamaica, Christmas must be nice. At least you're not, freezing. Enjoy it. Yes, good night, everyone, wherever you are. How are you spending your Christmas Eve? Are you ready for tomorrow? Yeah, family and friends. Yes, it is a good season. It is a good time. We give God praise and we give him glory. Again, thank you for joining me on this, Christmas Eve, as we, we play some Christmas songs. This is how we do it on Real Talk. a savior. Christ the Lord. Yeah. Yes, once again, top of the evening, everyone, everywhere. Yes, welcome to Real Talk. It is New Day here on this, your Christmas Eve night. Yes, just playing a little bit of, Jamaican Christmas songs for those of you down there in Jamaica. As I was just speaking to my sister just now, I said, I've never spent a Christmas in Jamaica, since I've been in Canada. I've been to Jamaica, but never around this time. So I don't know what it's like, this time, but I'm sure it's fun. It's nice. The weather must be nice. You're going to enjoy yourself. You know what I mean? Under the sun. Glory to God. I'm sure it's very festive down there. As for us here on this side of the globe, it is bitter cold outside. You know, I was on my way from work and I made a stop and I just head straight home because I'm saying to myself, no, I cannot deal with it. It's just rigid. And I started thinking about our homeless community, those who, are on our streets. And I'm thinking, God, I'm trusting that they will get in somewhere and keep themselves warm as the temperatures plunge. I'm more than sure it's minus something, glory to God. So if you're down there in Jamaica, if you're in Trinidad, if you are anywhere in the Caribbean just about now, be grateful, be thankful. That the weather Virgin Mary is treating you good.
Virgin Mary had a baby boy.
Virgin Mary had a baby boy.
And they said that his name was Jesus. Him come from the glory.
Oh, yes, believer.
Oh, yes, believer.
bless the name of the Lord indeed. We trust that you will have a merry, merry Christmas. Yes, don't forget why we are celebrating, you know, the reason. Yeah, Jesus is the reason. We don't want to forget that.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining.
Yes, they are shining.
It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long may the world in sin.
This evening, today actually, you know, if my mom was still around, she would have been 86 years old. Yeah, she is was a New Year's Eve, Christmas Eve baby. Yep, she would have been celebrating 86 years, but you know what? God knows best. Glory to God, yes. And for those of you, you know, at this time of the year, you know, it's a mixed feelings for a lot of people. You know, some people love this time of the year. They love Christmas. Some people just love the Christmas, the festive, the food and all of that. But then you have some people who, you know, they wish they can sleep out this entire time. You know, why? Because they're hurting for some reason, you know, whether it's the loss of a loved one or just there's just a bad memory around this time. You know, so I trust that, you know, that this season, this time, that you'll find something to be happy about. You know, I was speaking to one of my colleagues, you know, she just lost her dad, you know, a couple of days ago. And that's it. You know what I mean? Like, you know, when things like that happen, it just puts a damper on, you know, just how things are. Let me see what's happening here. Yeah, sorry. Just puts a damper on things, you know. So again, you know, my condolence goes out to her. Today I was at work and I got a phone call, you know, a sister in Christ. You know, she passed away, like, you know, this morning, you know, and I'm thinking, oh God, I was like sitting, I was like, oh my God, you know, why today? You know what I mean? So there's a family, you understand, who, you know, this time now doesn't really mean, you know, are they not too festive? As I was talking to my colleague and she was saying, like, you know, I just don't feel the festive season. I don't feel like doing anything. It's just not a good time for me, you know. So we just want to extend our condolence to those who have lost, you know, someone throughout the course of this week, or even today, as did this particular family that I know, losing a mother, grandmother, today. So it's like every year now on this date, they're going to remember that pain of losing their mom, you know, a husband losing his wife today. You know, and I asked the question, you know, what does Christmas really mean to you? You know what I mean? Is it about, you know, the gifts? Is it about spending quality time with your family? You know, are you the type of person that likes to go out and give out to the community? Many of us like to do that. You know, you look forward to this time of the year to get out on the streets. And it's not just this time, but, you know, you've been doing it all in the summer. But, you know, there's just something about Christmas when you give. You know, many persons will offer a meal. Is it a time that you open your house? Like, you know, what are you going to be doing this Christmas? You know, how are you going to, you know, demonstrate the love of God in your plans this Christmas? Let me hear from you. Type it in chat. Some people around the world, they don't even, you know that it's Christmas time. Yep. They don't even know that it's Christmas time. Yeah, they're probably somewhere where there's war that's happening. There's famine, all sorts of things, you know. So today is just another day for them, another day that they're trying to survive. Yes, tomorrow will be another day where, you know, they're hoping to get something to eat. You know what I'm trying to say? So, yeah, not everybody really looks at it the way you and I look at it. And we got to keep those people also in our thoughts. Yeah. Oh. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Let us play a little bit of this. As I said, you know, not everyone, knows that it's Christmas. And there's no need to be afraid.
At Christmas time,
we burn in life and we vanish shade. In our world
of plenty, we can
set aside. Yep. Let's do that.
Throw your arms
around the world at Christmas time. Let's say a prayer. Pray for the other one.
At Christmas time,
it's hard, but when you're having fun, there's a world outside your window.
And it's a world of fear.
Yes. Again, as I said, you know, as we are about to celebrate this year, Christmas, yep, there is a world out there that they're not celebrating. Yep, there's some children that they won't be opening any presents. Yep, just think about the children in Ukraine and, in all other nations that, yep, they're not celebrating. They don't even realize it's Christmas. Let us pray for them. Let us pray for them. Let's go out with this one. Who remembers this? Years ago. It's Christmas time. There's no need to be afraid. At Christmas time, we let in light and we banish shade. In our world of plenty, Boy George, smile of joy. Your arms around the world at Christmas time. But say a prayer. Pray for the other one. That Christmas time, it's hard, but when you're having fun, there's a world outside your window. And it's a world. Tears. No bells are ringing there. Now thank God it's them instead of you. When it won't be snowing in Africa this Christmas. Countries, do they know that it's Christmas time? Yeah. The world. Yes. Do they really know that it's Christmas? Do they know that it's Christmas Eve? We have so much to be grateful for. In the name of the Lord, glory to God, hallelujah. Yes, I just want to thank you for joining me this evening. Yes, I just wanted to come on, glory to God, to publicly wish you and your entire family, glory to God, from myself and the entire Real Talk community. You know, we wish you a happy, joyous, pleasant Christmas. By God's grace, you will be around, yes, to see it, glory to God, yeah, and to enjoy it. Nothing good that we have done. You know, as I played this song, as I said, some people don't even know it's Christmas. They don't know it's Christmas Eve. You know, let's think about those children that's in Ukraine. Glory to God, even Russia, there's some people even in Jamaica, glory to God, where you are, that they won't be opening a present tomorrow, you understand, they won't be getting a hot meal tomorrow, you understand, they're just thinking of how they're going to survive tonight, you know what I'm trying to say. So I just want us to really, you know, look back and ask yourself, you know, what does this time really mean to you? As I said before, is it about the food? Is it about the present? You know, as I said, some persons are mourning the loss of a family member. Glory to God. I just received a phone call today. You understand? A mother is no longer here. A wife, a grandmother, you know, died early this morning. Glory to God. And I said to myself when I got the call, I said, good God Almighty. I said, Father God, on today, you know, just the brink, a couple more hours and she would have made it to Christmas. And that is going to be somebody's reality, that all the planning that you're planning is only by the grace of God. You know what I'm trying to say? So as you enjoy your family, you know, as you, you know, sit down at your table, and at this time of the year, there's so much food, you know, I'm telling you, food upon food upon food. When you stand and look at your dinner table tomorrow, give God thanks that you have choice. You have a choice whether you want to eat. You know, I overheard somebody today saying that, you know, she's going to cook oxtail and she's cooking this. And she was just listing out everything. And I sat and I'm thinking, wow, that's a lot of food. And yet still there'll be somebody that doesn't have anything to eat. You understand? Should you not enjoy yourself because somebody else doesn't have anything to eat? Of course, enjoy yourself, enjoy your family. But all I'm saying is do it with a grateful heart. You know, do it with a heart of thanksgiving, because while you have, somebody else doesn't have. And that's why it's so important that, you know, you reach out to somebody, you know, tomorrow who, you know, you understand, maybe they lost a child, you know, maybe, you know, they lost a job and they're struggling. Invite them over to your place. You know what I mean? Or, you know, if you can't invite them over, take something over, glory to God. Nobody should be alone at this time. You know what I mean? Nobody should be, you know, just shut away and no. You understand? Let us reach out, you know, to somebody that we know that's going through some hard time, you understand, and make this, you know, a season, a festive one. And for those of you, if you're a family member, I encourage you to hug them up. You understand? Let them know how much you love them. You know what I mean? Because, I mean, oh God Almighty, we don't know. You understand? You don't know if this is going to be last. And it's not about speaking negative. A lot of people say, oh, you know what? Don't speak negative. But it's a reality. We do not know. You understand what I'm trying to say? You know, I didn't know that my mother was not going to be here to celebrate her 86th birthday, but she's not, glory to God. You know, again, my friend lost her dad just a couple of days ago. She bought a ticket to go to Jamaica, wanted to go to see him. He's no longer here. You know what I'm trying to say? This family this morning, the loss, you know, of their mother right now. You know, so we don't know. So when you look at your family around the table, though dysfunctional, you know, you might not agree about everything. Appreciate each other, love on each other. You know what I'm saying? This is a season of love and embrace, and, you know, just to have some, yeah, some good, clean fellowship. All right. Because remember, there's lots of people out there that's hurting. You know, again, as I said, if you can extend, you know, your hand to somebody this holiday, this Christmas season, do so. Do so. Glory to God. Again, remember those who are struggling. Remember those who don't have it. You know, some people, they don't want to talk. They don't want to, you know, say that they don't have it. You understand what I'm trying to say? You know, so ask the Holy Spirit, you know, to place somebody upon your heart. Yeah, ask him to place somebody upon your heart that you can bless this holiday season. All right. You know, and open your doors if you can, because again, as I said, God has been so good to us, so good to us, glory to God, that we can't complain, glory to God. All right, so let me play a little bit of this, and I'm going to head out of here. Yes, not everybody knows it's Christmas time. Yeah, Haiti is under crisis. You think that, you know, they realize it's Christmas time. Even some remote places in Jamaica. Yeah. Body was found. Do they know it's Christmas time? Are they celebrating?
You let in life and you vanish it.
Yeah.
Our world of plenty.
Many of us have plenty. And some people have nothing.
Around the world at Christmas time. But say a prayer.
Let's pray for them.
Pray for the other one. At Christmas time, it's hard, but we're not having fun.
They're not having any fun.
There's a world outside your window. And there's a world of virtue.
Yes, just fear.
The only water's flowing
is their bitter tears. You got a lot to give God thanks for. You got a lot to give him thanks for, yes.
Thank God it's them instead of you.
You know, as we approach only a couple more days, few more days to go. Yes, a few more days to go. My God, what a year has it been? I don't know what this year was to you. You know, I don't know what your struggles were. I don't know what you had to go through, what you had to endure, you know, but God has been so good to you. Yep, you I'm talking to. God has been gracious to you. He has been so good to you, better than you could have ever been to yourself, glory to God. And the fact that you're still here, you know what you went through, you understand? You know that there was times when you thought you're going to lose your mind. You know there was times that you just wanted to give up. You know there was times when you know without a shadow of a doubt that God carried you, that he protected you. Yes, you. Glory to God. You know that it's because of him while you're still here. You know that when you were sick, he's the one that healed you. He was the one that came through for you. When your back was against the wall, when everybody turned against you, he was still there for you. Come on, it's been a year, God, of triumph and victory and disappointment. You had to go through the storm. You had to endure some things. You understand what I'm trying to say? But look at you now. You're still here on this Christmas Eve. God is good. You're even surprised that you're still here. But God is a good God. So as you spend time with your family and friends, just reflect on the goodness of God. You know, there's many persons are debating the date and the month and whatever that Jesus Christ was born. We are not debating it. The fact that he was born, it's good enough for us. Glory to God. I was encouraging, you know, my group, and I was talking about, you know, how, you know, when he was born, you understand where his birth was. Nowadays, you know, when we go to have babies, we're in birthing rooms and all the gadgets and everything is there. And man, massive, nice place. But just think about, you understand, the birth of our Savior. The real meaning and the reason why we are celebrating. Yeah. The birth of our Savior. The one who came to die. Oh, yes. The one who was born to take upon himself all our sin. The one who said, I will go. That's why we're celebrating. The one who became our substitute. The one who knew no sin. That's what we are talking. And that's what we need to reflect on. When you sit around your dinner table, reflect on the one who provided. The one who took upon himself our sickness and dealt with it until it was finished. That's what we're thinking about. We should be thinking about and be so much appreciative. Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the Savior of the world. For God so loved the world that he gave us his best. Many of us would never give people our best. Oh, yeah. You have that Chanel perfume, or you have that, you know, that some designer bag that costs you like thousands of dollars. You understand? I'm sure if somebody asked you for it and you know it was your best, you would probably if and but, I don't know if I want to let go of that. But he gave us his best. And as we open those gifts, because some people, this season is about gifts. It's about the present and you know how expensive it is and whatever you criticize. Some of us like wish we were going to get something more expensive, but just think about the gift of salvation. Yes. That gift. That gift that has been sitting under the tree for year in and year out, day in and day out, glory to God. That gift is not just there at Christmas time. It's there every second of the day. It's available. That gift of salvation. Which you pass by every day. The gift of eternal life, which has been offered and it's there for each and every one of us. Some of us have accepted it and we're glad for it and we appreciate it, but there's still many of us who ruffle under the tree and we pick up every other gift. But we leave this one and we say, you know what? I thank you for this gift, but I'm not ready for this yet. Tomorrow. Nah, I'm not ready for this yet. Maybe next week, maybe next year. And it's so funny, I'm saying this, thank you, Holy Spirit. You know, I came home and I was looking for something. And while I was going through, you know, my closet, I found a gift bag. Oh, Holy Spirit, you are such an amazing. I tell you, the Holy Spirit speaks to us, you know, I'm telling you. And he's using what happened early before I came on to now demonstrate what some of us do. You know, so I was looking for something and then I found this gift bag. And in the gift bag, there's lots of goodies in there. You understand? There was shampoo and conditioner, nice top of the line one. There's, you know, some body wash and there's a lotion to it and from Bath and Body Works place, you know, nice one. And it was there for, I don't know how long, because I moved, you understand, from where I was living because I didn't get that gift recently. So when I was moving, I took it with me. So I don't even know which year. I got that. But just think about it. It was just sitting there. And that's what happens to some of us. The gift of salvation has been given and provided over 2,000 years ago, and it's still sitting there. Oh, yeah. So when I took it down and I opened up, I saw all these things. I was like, man, all these goodies is inside of there. That's what's happened. Will you make up in your mind that you are going to receive and accept the gift of salvation? Stop leaving it under the tree. Stop putting it away in the closet. Stop hiding it. Open it up. Receive it. Just like how, and it's funny too, when I found this thing, I came and I had a shower and I used the shampoo and the conditioner and washed my hair and conditioned my hair. It's been there for so long. What am I saying? Thank you, Holy Spirit. That's what many persons do year after year, day after day. They've been given it. It's been given to them, but they refuse to accept it. This gift of salvation is better than any gift that you'll receive. Some of you, the gift that you're getting, you have to work your way. You understand what I'm trying to say? Yes, you cook and you clean. And your husband might say, you know what? You deserve that. You understand what I'm trying to say? Some of us, you understand, if we never cook and clean, we're not getting anything. Oh, yeah. But this gift, whether you cooked, you clean or didn't clean or didn't, it's still yours. Yep. It's not like Santa Claus, you know, whether you're naughty, you understand? If you're naughty, you're not going to get it. You understand? You're naughty, it's still. If you're nice, it's still. Yeah. So I pray that this season, as you're opening the gifts, for those of you who have not accepted, I pray that you'll accept the gift of salvation. The precious gift. It wasn't cheap. And the thing about it is, it's freely given to you, but it cost the giver dearly. Pain and agony. It was so bad that one of the time he wanted to change his mind, but guess what? He couldn't, because guess what? He loved you and I so much. He said, nevertheless. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Yeah. I trust that you will accept this gift that has been offered to you. The whosoever's. Yeah. There's no greater gift than this gift. And I pray that you'll accept it. You'll receive it with open arms. Again, it's better than anything that you'll receive. God is a good God. So let us not miss the reason why we are celebrating. Again, as I said, we can debate the date, the month, the season, but it's not about that. But one thing that's not debatable is the fact that he was born and that he died and that he rose again. Yeah. So with that being said, I want to take this time, and as I said, and I want to wish each and every one of you, from my home to yours, from the entire Real Talk community, those who are behind the scenes that you don't know, because we are a community, I wish you a Merry Christmas. I wish you peace, joy, and happiness. And I pray that if your family has been dysfunctional all year, I pray tomorrow that there'll be healing, that there'll be forgiveness. Yeah. I pray that for you. For those of you who are mourning the loss of a loved one that passed away recently, my condolences to you and your entire family. May the God of all comfort comfort your heart. Again, as I said, while you sit and eat, remember our homeless community. Remember our children that are in war-torn countries. Remember those in Ukraine and Russia, those who are in Haiti, those down there in Malaysia. I believe that each and every one of us, when we sit at our dinner table, that we should hold a minute of silence and let us remember. Yeah. As you eat, remember those who don't have to eat and pray that God will also provide for them. The Lord bless you and the Lord keep you. Again, as I said, happy New Year. No. Merry Christmas to you. Again, it was a privilege serving you today. I just came by just to play some songs and just to encourage us. And the Lord bless you and the Lord keep you. Enjoy. Enjoy your meal. Enjoy your fellowship. Just find something to give God thanks for. Again, as I said, reach out to somebody that you know that's going through some hard time. Invite them over. All right. Again, nobody should be alone. As for me, I'll be spending this Christmas with, actually, my grandbabies are due anytime now. And I'm thanking God for them. You know, yes, I thank God for them. I thank God for my daughter. I thank God for my family. You know, I thank God that I'm off tomorrow too, that I can spend that quality time with them. You know, for those of you who are working, you know, tomorrow, I thank God for you that you will be with somebody who doesn't have somebody. Many of us are frontline workers and we work with people who don't have any families, you know, so we're their family on that day. The Lord bless you and all that you do for those who have been forgotten. Yeah. So again, Merry Christmas, Canada. When it comes, and for those of you around the world, looking forward to ending off this year with you strong, all right? There'll be no programs tomorrow and on Monday, but we will be back here on the 29th at 6:30 p.m., the year in review, where we'll take you back from January until now, just giving you a little bit of what we've been doing over the years and over the year and leading up to our last night. All right. So have yourself again wonderful night. Good night to the entire world. Remember, wherever you are around the world, you have the heart of a champion, the mind of an overcomer, the spirit of more than a conqueror, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Remember, you are a lit candle. Go out and light your world. Go out and love on somebody. Again, let us remember to pray for the sick and the afflicted. Yes, let us remember to pray for those who are struggling, you know, with mental illness. We know it's real, it's subtle, it's a silent killer. Let us check up on people, especially if we haven't heard from them. But let us check up on them. Glory to God. Let us really be our brother's keeper. Again, as I said, this time of year, so many persons go on a depression. All right, so let's reach out to those. All right, good night to the entire world.